This new background removal technique can extract a person from a single input image, without the need for a green screen or additional information in real time at up to 63 frames per second. Let's see how they achieved that, and more awesome results. This is What's AI, and I share artificial intelligence news every week. If you are new to the channel and want to stay up to date, please consider subscribing to not miss any further news. Human matting is an extremely interesting task where the goal is to find any human in a picture and remove the background from it. It is really hard to achieve due to the complexity of the task, having to find the person or people with the perfect contour. Many techniques are using basic computer vision algorithms to achieve this task, such as the grab cut algorithm, which is extremely fast but not very precise. This grab cut algorithm basically estimates the color distribution of the foreground item and the background using a Gaussian mixture model. This is why we often use a green screen, helping the algorithm to remove only the green pixels and leave the rest into the final results. But the results are not so great when we do not have access to such a green screen. Modern deep learning and the power of our GPUs made it possible to create much powerful applications that are yet not perfect. The best example here is Deep Image Matting, made by Adobe Research in 2017. A version of this model is currently used in most websites you use to automatically remove the background from your pictures. Unfortunately, this technique needs two inputs, an image and its tri-map. A tri-map is basically a representation of the image in three levels: the background, the foreground, and a region where the pixels are considered as a mixture of foreground and background, looking like this. To successfully remove the background using the deep image matting technique, we need a powerful network able to localize the person somewhat accurately. Then, we produce a segmentation where the pixels equivalent to the person are set to 1 and the rest of the image is set to 0. Then, we use basic computer vision transformations to create a tri-map from this segmentation. We start by reducing the size of the segmented object to leave a bit of space for the unknown region by eroding it, removing some pixels at the contour of the object iteratively. Then, we add this third section, which is the unknown region, by dilating the object, adding pixels around the contour, producing a result like this. This tri-map is the one we sent to the deep image matting model with the original image, and you get your output. You can see how much computation power is needed for this technique, using two powerful models if you would like to achieve somewhat accurate results. As you just saw, the current state-of-the-art approaches are quite accurate, but they need a few seconds and sometimes up to minutes to find the results for a single image. You can just imagine the time it will need to process a whole video. Fortunately for us, this new technique can process human matting from a single input image without the need for a green screen or a tri-map in real time at up to 63 frames per second. They call their network MudNet. It's a lightweight matting objective decomposition network, which we will further detail. They train their network in both a supervised and self-supervised way. The supervised way takes an input and learns to remove the background based on a corresponding ground truth, just like usual networks. Then, there is a self-supervised training process. This is called self-supervised because this network does not have access to the ground truth of the videos it is trained on. It uses unlabeled data and has access to the information found in the previous step, which are the parameters of the network. It basically takes what the first network learned and understands the consistency between the object in each frame to correctly remove the background. These two trainings are made on the MudNet architecture. MudNet is basically composed of three main branches. There is a low-resolution branch, which estimates the human semantics. Then, based on these results, the original image and the ground truth of the image, a high-resolution branch focuses on detecting precise human boundaries. Finally, a fusion branch, also supervised by the whole ground truth mat, is added to predict the final result of the alpha mat, which will be used to remove the background of the input image. This network architecture is way faster, because it first finds the semantic estimation itself using a basic decoder inside the low resolution branch, making it much faster to process. As you can see, the network is basically mainly composed of downsampling, convolutions, and upsampling. An arbitrary CNN architecture can be used where you see the convolutions happening. In this case, they used MobileNet V2 because it was made for mobile devices. It is a small network and extremely efficient when compared to other state-of-the-art architectures. If you are not familiar with convolutional neural networks, or CNNs, I invite you to watch the video I made explaining what they are. It will be in the top right of the screen and linked in the description below. The downsampling and the use of fewer convolutional layers in the high-resolution branch is done to reduce the computational time. This fusion branch is just a CNN module used to combine the semantics and details where an upsampling has to be made if we want the accurate details around the semantics. Finally, the results are measured using a loss highly inspired from the Deep Image Matting paper. It calculates the absolute difference between the input image and the composited image obtained from the ground truth foreground and the ground truth background. Now, there's one last step to this network's architecture. If we come back to the full architecture here, we can see that they apply what they called a one-frame delay, which uses the information of the precedent frame and the following frame to fix the unknown pixels hesitating between foreground and background. Here, you can see an example where the foreground moves slightly to the left in three consecutive frames, and the pixels does not correspond to what it is supposed to, with the red pixel flickering in the second iteration. Then, you have your final results with the foreground object extracted, which is a person in this case, and you can add in many different backgrounds. Of course, this was just a simple overview of this new paper. I strongly recommend to read the paper for a deeper understanding of this new technique. The code and a pre-trained model will also be available soon on their GitHub, as they wrote on their page. Both are linked in the description below. Please leave a like if you went this far in the video. And since there are over 90% of you guys watching that are not subscribed yet, consider subscribing to the channel to not miss any further news clearly explained. Thank you for watching.